I was just wondering whether all the events that occur in our lives, is it down, has been written for us by God's plan, or is it our own decisions that influence our lives and what events occur in our lives?
You see, if you become a fatalist, fatalist means everything is fixed, I have no power over it, and I have to just sit down and die and let things kind of hit me, because I have no control on what is going to happen to me. This is called fatalism. If many Hindus become fatalist, because oh, it's written law of karma is catching up, oh dear, let me, you know, I give silly example, but I won't do that, they've done enough. But suppose you be a fatalist, does it agree with Hindu? No! Comes the teaching of Vivekananda. He said, don't you know? You have opportunity to change your future. If somebody says written in the stars or in the planets that this will happen to you, then say I'm going to move the planets. I'll shift the planets. How dare they get in my interfere in my life? Don't play dead against material forces. Stand up and fight. So if things go against you, they gang up against you. Oh, look, not because you are a bad man or a bad person. Things have a habit of ganging up. Look, the whole creation is like that. Sometimes things gang up. What do? You say, oh, let it happen. No, don't you dare. Vivekananda will get angry. I will get, and I say, look, what are you doing? You are not understood your religion. Your reasons, roll up your sleeves and come fighting. Choose your destiny, mold your destiny. You are in charge of your destiny. Even though all the forces, you know, try and act against you to put you down, you fight, come fighting. So what? Come fighting. So the idea is, even though things sometimes gang up against you, and we all of us have that experience, things sometimes go wrong. So what? You know, alert yourself, assert yourself, sit up and take notice and react and fight back. You see, this is the message of man making, woman making religion, a message of power, empowering humanity to chart its own destiny. Do not fall dead. Again, you see, you may think, oh, Dilip Pangal is making it look, it's this part of your biology. You know how I started? I said it is very crucial to define a living organism as that interacts with its environment. You know what's the unique feature about this? Is how we define a living thing. And if you not, you study biology at even a high level, I give you the simple answer. If you've got a living organism and you prod it, if it's a dead thing, you can direct it and push it. If it's a living thing, it will react to you. It will not like being prodded, it will go, ouch, and react. This is the sign of life. You don't play, if you like, play along with the forces of nature and allow them to overpower you. You stand up against this, I am bigger than you. This is the whole story of humanity. Standing up against the forces of nature and asserting ourselves, conquering nature external and internal, and revealing our own divinity. This is what religion teaches. This is the new definition of religion. Do you think this I'm just making up? Look, see, I mean, this thing, electricity, it was in the clouds. And in the ancient days, this used to come out of the clouds from time to time as a thunderbolt and go, boom, and we go, oh, God, messages, we used to bow down, the old man, the old Stone Age man. We said, nothing doing, he's not going to prod me. I'm going to capture it, put it in wires and light up my house. Fighting nature is inherent in all of us. Don't you dare lose heart. Stand up, take on the challenge. This is what humanity, this is what life, this is what the spirit is all about. Take on the challenges. So you mold your own destiny. How dare anything else external come and stop you, get in your way. You stand up. This, my friends, look, youngsters, this is the teaching of Swami Vivekananda. When I present this idea, say some of these top colleges like Eton, the youngsters start applauding, never, don't stop. Nobody has given them that dignity, that empowerment to sort themselves out. Heart of Hindu religion, empowering humanity. This is what it's all about.